Welcome to another Stories from the Stores. Now today we're joined by curator Alex Rose, and she's told me that this instrument can measure ozone. Alex, how does it work?
Ozone is a gas that's produced up in the stratosphere, so that's a layer of the Earth's atmosphere that's between 10 and 50 kilometres up. And ozone absorbs UV light from the sun.
Okay, like a layer of sun cream.
Basically like a layer of sun cream. And that's the principle, basically, that this instrument uses to measure ozone. It was made in 1924 by a university professor called Gordon Dobson in his shed. And he realised that no one had taken regular measurements of ozone, basically, and he wanted to create a more continuous data set. So he constructed this instrument to do that. It would have been mounted so that you could adjust the height. There's a scale on this side where you can see what angle it's pointing at so that you could angle it at the sun or whatever angle you wanted.
Is that why it's got a bubble meter?
Yeah, exactly, so that he could calculate the height. It has a filter up this end that separated out the wavelengths of light that he was interested in recording. There's a prism here that kind of splits out the light, and then the readings would have been taken on a photographic plate that sat just down there.
Okay, so he's taking all of these readings, right? Did he find that hole in the ozone layer?
He didn't, because in 1924 it didn't exist. What he did discover was that the levels of ozone weren't constant, but they fluctuated a lot. So they varied daily, they varied annually, seasonally.
So did they use this object to discover that hole in the ozone layer?
It was a modern version of this instrument stationed at Antarctica, actually, that a number of British scientists were looking at measurements from, and they realised that levels of ozone were much lower than they were expecting and were declining. So after the initial findings in the mid-1980s, there was a big international research project that confirmed the findings that there was a hole in the ozone layer. And the world came together to ban the use of CFCs in manufacturing industry, which was the cause of the hole.
And that's all thanks to Dobson.
Exactly. So scientists still use his name every time they take measurements, because the modern versions of this instrument are called Dobson meters by scientists. And the unit of measurement for atmospheric ozone, in fact, bears his name. It's called the Dobson.